Okay, welcome to Extra Extra Time, only available on YouTube. Again, similar to the show, we'd like to dedicate the Extra Extra Time to Davide Astori, the Fiorentina player who died at the weekend of a cardiac arrest. I remember him fondly as a supporter of Cagliari Calcio, hence the cap there.
It's also worth saying, for, as a Brighton fan, that our centre-back, Conor Goldson, had something like that discovered in a routine check last season. And it was brilliant. It was picked up in time.
Well, they have changed the rules, haven't they?
You've got to,
Moamba brought, obviously, his incident.
You know, it's such a, you know, people talk about tragedy in football. That's tragedy.
Yeah. So young as well, 31.
Yeah. Well, because of that, all Italian games were suspended yesterday. There was a little bit of action on Saturday night, both Juventus and Napoli playing.
Well, they're doing a minute silence at all European games, Europa League and Champions League tomorrow for him.
That's going to be good. It's definitely worth thinking about, I think. Okay, so moving on to slightly less important matters. In 3 weeks' time, we've got the international break, which for many club fans, especially in the Premier League anyway, is kind of treated, I don't know, not really looked forward to that much. However, I think it's a really important opportunity for fans of larger teams to head down the leagues for non-league day. Why is that, Attila? What's going on? What usually happens for these non-league days?
Well, it's quite simple. You get, get the local non-league and lower league teams. It is mainly non-league. In saying, you've got a big city which has, you know, a non-league side in it. I mean, the obvious one being FC United.
It's also Salford now, isn't it?
Salford, yeah, there's Salford. And, of course, here we've got Whitehall, who are the sort of St. Pauli of Brighton, really. in a tiny little way, and it's very strangely run. Leaving that aside, they've got a really, really good fan group. The Whitehall Culture is about 200. They're a really good laugh. And there's, you can drink beer, stand on the terrace and drink real ale. It's really good.
And it should be.
And I can tell you that the Hawks Ultras make 200 Hawks Ultras in a 400 crowd at Whitehall make more noise than you in most third and fourth division games. Nice. I mean, seriously, you know.
So they're in National League South.
They're in National League South. They're bottom by miles, but they were really, really bottom by loads of miles, and now they're winning all the time because the owners have put a load of money in suddenly. It's strangely run, shall we say, being diplomatic, but the fans are brilliant.
And how would the fans perceive people going down, maybe who aren't regulars for this non-league?
Totally. I mean, absolutely, totally welcome it. Absolutely, totally, totally. I mean, that's the whole idea of Whitehawk is, as a club here, for people who move to Brighton for business or family or whatever, have no connection with Brighton or Albion and want to go and watch a football match. I mean, they have one of their chances. We're the Northern. Whitehawk fans, and they go, we're the Southern. I mean, it's people from all over, literally all over Britain and Eastern, lots from Eastern Europe as well go and watch them. Wow. Lots of people that work over here. One of the leaders of the Ultras is a Polish guy called Adam. Lovely bloke. And they really do welcome everybody. I mean, it's a great place to go.
We talked about, I think on two shows ago, we talked about the concept of people supporting clubs from cities that they're not from necessarily. But like you were saying, for Whitehawk, it's not a problem if you go down and you're not...
Well, no, I mean, it's more than not a problem. It's what is expected. I mean, like I said to you the other week, I mean, I would expect and hope, especially now, that people born and bred in Brighton would support Brighton. Yeah. But Whitehawk is an obvious port of call for people who want to watch the game on Saturday afternoon, have a laugh, have a few beers, and who've got no connection to Brighton or Albion. And it obviously is really difficult to get tickets now because we're doing so well. You can walk into Whitehawk, you can stand on a terrace, it's a terrace.
It's so much more accessible for people to just go watch.
That's right, you know.
I mean, I love watching football, so.
Yeah, you get a few. there's a few of us that go. Some of our North Stand Collective lot go when we're not playing, obviously, you know. I go probably three or four times a season when we're not playing. It's really good fun. I mean, it really is good fun.
Great. Rhymie, do you think it's important for people to go to the club slightly lower down lower down the football pyramid?
Yeah, and like you were saying, if it's to go and see, even Brighton can be difficult. To go all the way to Liverpool is really expensive and really difficult as well to get tickets. So, no, definitely. If it's really simple, if it's as simple as just going down to the ground, and, you know, buy. Is it like that? You just go and buy your ticket?
You know, you just go and you get in. Lewis is another one locally. So, Lewis is a completely fan-owned club. They've got this. They've got Harvey's on tap. You know,
you drink that
on the terrace. Well, Worthing are doing. Yeah. Worthing have got a good scene going now. They had over 1,000 on, obviously, because we were playing on Sunday. Yeah. They played Billericay with their league leaders on Saturday. They won 2-1, and they had more than 1,200 people there.
That's amazing.
You know, and that was great. You know,
so absolutely. It's worth pointing out in the Brighton area. Then we've got Whitehawk, we've got Worthing, and Lewis.
Yeah. And there's more, but if you just name those three, that's a good start, absolutely.
Are numbers in, like, lower league clubs' attendance, like, rising? Because obviously people are looking at it now and going, oh, yeah, no, it's so expensive to take.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, there are many, I know many people, there's lots of people of my age specifically who have basically given up supporting big Premier League sides because they can't afford it or because they're just totally hacked off with modern football.
Yeah.
I mean, Dulwich Hamlet is an example of a London club, which is, they're getting 2,000 people at their home games now. You know, lots of people, some of them are obviously people that have given up on Palace, which is always, but I mean, you know, there is a real upsurge in interest in non-league football, and it is. I mean, if you feel like I do, I mean, I could never be like that. I don't think I could anyway. But especially with what we went through, for me, it's just brilliant supporting the Albion. Yeah. But I can understand how somebody who supported, you know, I mean, Arsenal, for instance. Yeah. I mean, we went to Highbury. We went to the Emirates, didn't we? There's 10,000 empty seats there, and there's loads and loads of people, working class people, who cannot afford to go because they can't afford to buy a season ticket.
It's like £90, so
The season tickets get sold to people who live hundreds of miles in different countries who are only playing Brighton, so they don't turn up. It's a joke. Yeah.
But is it important, do you think, for young kids especially, who have maybe been priced out of the Premier League? They've got this experience of going to the game, to walk out on the stands to get the atmosphere.
There's loads of, I've got to say, the majority of the people who go to Whitehawk are young kids.
This is a problem, especially I think with Anfield, for example, or Old Trafford, is without a doubt the average age of these supporters is rising all the time.
I mean, you know, I noticed, I mean, you know, when especially with the away crowds, because of the way with our away crowds, I mean because of the nature of the loyalty points and everything and the way the season ticket stuff works,
rubbish.
I mean, honestly, you know, I'm noticing this. I mean, I'm 60 and I'm thinking, well, an awful lot of our fans are about my age, you know, and because we've all been through that whole lot of stuff together, we've all come through, and of course, so we've all got the loyalty points, you know, accumulated through literally being loyal in the worst of times, and it does mean, unfortunately, that, you know, that there are fewer tickets available for some of the, although there's a lot of the younger lot get in too. I mean, it seems to work okay, but certainly at home, in terms of the home season ticket holders, the big clubs, it really is bad.
Is this something you're interested in, Sean, do you think? Sort of going down the leagues and watching football?
Yeah, I paid a lot of close attention to Sutton United when they had their FA Cup run. I thought they were great. And it is
and for Wimbledon,
right to,
I mean...
Wimbledon, you know, they're a perfect example of a club that
have
just done so well to get back in
the Ian McNay, Cherry Red Records.
It's so important to give at least pay some attention to your local team, because otherwise... That is grassroots football, it's core, essentially. And it's that everything that, like what you have said, like the aspect of money, it doesn't matter in this sort of, like, in that club. And it's if you do truly love the game, I guess.
In the old days...
I wish it was advertised a bit better, though. You know, the fact that you can go to Whitehawk. Because I think a lot of people don't...
Yeah,
do you not think that's the hidden secret, then, though?
No, it's all over social media.
You know, I mean, I love watching football, and I don't even know how much it is.
It's a tenner.
A tenner, you know, and I think
and
a lot five of
if
people...
You're five are unemployed, like, and kids getting for nothing, so...
I think a lot of the foreign students who are coming, I think it should be tapped into
a tenner, that's 2 pints in it when you're watching a game or whatever, you know, that's...
These days, it's not... It's a Whitehawk, I think it's £3.50 a pint.
No, I mean, you
were
watching
before,
every week.
Hell, we're £4.50 a pint now. We're £4.50 a pint now.
So, just to confirm then... We have focused quite a bit on Whitehawk, but Whitehawk, non-league weekends, or in general, I mean, it shouldn't just be non-league weekend, should it? I mean, if you're interested in Whitehawk or Lewis or Worthing or any other local non-league clubs, then don't feel that you have to go only on this one weekend.
It's a simple idea for people, as I say, for people who move to the area, who've got no connection with the Albion. If you want to watch a game of football, then
I think it's doing something good as well.
There's enough people at all the. It's really good fun. It's a really good atmosphere. You know, it's just really good. It's like football as it used to be. I remember when I was growing up, this is where the players of the work with the old First Division. That's where the players came from. You started off playing in non-league. Then you went. There was none of these academies or anything then. You started off in non-league. Then you worked your way up the league if you were good. So when I was 10, 11, 12, 15, whatever. If I went and seen my local Southwick team, then a couple of years later, some of them would play for Brighton. You know, that's all different now.
Simply put, because we do need to wrap it up, Whitehawk, we are going to come and see you for sure. I think. Yeah. An extra time outing to Whitehawk. Beer on the terrace.
Yeah.
We'll see you there.